welcome. I am Reverend Lisa Ann, and it is a joy and a privilege to be here today. On behalf of Kyle and Kyla, I want to thank you all for taking time out of your busy lives to join us here under the eyes of the Lord as we witness the union of Kyle and Kyla in marriage. They would like me to please ask everyone to make sure that your cell phones have been placed in your pockets or in your purses. They promise they will share pictures. Thank you so much. Kyle and Kyla have chosen each and every one of us to be here with them today to witness their wedding vows as they join together as husband and wife. This is our task, our special honor. Our being here is what makes this moment sacred and valuable. So please, everyone, take a moment now to take a deep breath and feel at peace as we celebrate and solemnize this union. We would like to take a moment now to acknowledge the family members that were not able to be present here with us today. We know that their spirits are here with us, sharing in our joy. We feel their presence, and we take solace in the knowledge that they would be thrilled to see this union. They are missed, and they will always remain in the hearts of those who love them. I'd like to take a few minutes now to talk about why I think these two are so right together. Their individual warmth and humor and light grow exponentially when they are together. I loved learning about them, like how they've been together since 2012, hanging out and going to the drive-in as friends first, but then got swept into a relationship. How they bought their house and 2.5 acres 5 years ago because they needed lots of room for Fletcher and Tucker, their dogs, and Journey, their cat. How they love to go to trivia at the Legion, and take long car rides and go to Benazette. How they're constantly going back to the roller rink where they met for parties and skating and drinking. How Kyle had the proposal planned during a trip to San Francisco, which got sidelined because of COVID. So we took them to Moraine State Park on June 13th. There's a spot that they always go to that overlooks the lake and has picnic tables. Kyle had set it up with Paul and Lauren so they could take pictures. Kyla had thought for sure that she'd know when it was happening. But she was so surprised that she described, "No, no, no!" Literally grabbed the ring box and pushed Kyle over before she said yes. Now, they didn't take into account that the spot might be occupied, which it was, with a family reunion, with one man asking if their dogs were wolves. I asked Kyle and Kyla to each tell me 5 things that they love about the other. Neither one knows what the other has written. So I would like to read those to you now. Kyla said, 1, you love helping others and are passionate about the things you love, like hunting and fishing. 2, I love how ambitious, determined, and hardworking you are. You're independent and you always finish what you start. 3, you're humble and open-minded. I love that you're never too proud and that you do all of the laundry. 4, you always provide encouragement and support when I need it. You empower me and help me accomplish my goals. 5, I'm grateful that when I want something, for instance, another dog, you give your opinion, which I value, but you back me, even if it's not ideal. And she has a number 6 bonus. You're the best doggy daddy, and I'm sorry that you always have to be the bad guy because they never do anything wrong. And Kyle said, 1, I love that Kyla is very smart and responsible with money, because Lord knows I am not. Two, I love that Kyla is hands down the most low-maintenance person that I have ever met. Three, I love that Kyla is very supportive of me no matter what. I tend to have hobbies that are ridiculous and expensive, and Kyla is always there to support me, no matter what. Four, I love Kyla's kind and caring spirit. She would do anything for anyone. It takes a truly special person to have the career that she has. She's always striving to help people in any way she can. Five, I love that Kyla is the most amazing mother of our fur babies. She would do absolutely anything for our pets, no matter what it takes and no matter what it cost. He's got a couple of bonuses here too. So, number six, I love that Kyla is adventurous and outgoing. I've always been kind of a homebody. Kyla has brought me out of my shell. I have met more people and seen more things than I ever could have imagined because of her. And seven, officially bonus. And he said, I know it's not necessarily a thing I love, it's more of a vow, but I wanted to put it down anyway. We have been through lots of ups and downs over the last 9 years. We've been through stressful times of having no money, to now having a beautiful home with two stable jobs and three amazing fur babies. We've accomplished more than I ever could have imagined, and I cannot wait to see what we accomplish in a lifetime together. And there isn't anyone else that I would want by my side for the rest of my life. I love you. You can see that these are two lives that have meshed in a perfect way, destined to become one here with us today. Because each of us knows that marriage is not created by law or by a ceremony. Rather, it occurs in the hearts of two people. It grows out of loving and caring and sharing ourselves with another. So as witnesses to this union, you are all charged with a very special responsibility to support and to encourage this couple throughout their years to come. Today, they have come before us to publicly affirm their love, to promise to nurture themselves, each other, and this union, and to acknowledge its significance in their lives. They do so knowing that marriage is at once the most tender, yet challenging, of all relationships in life. Your love for one another and your willingness to accept each other's strengths and weaknesses with insight and consideration will help cement the foundation for a strong and lasting marriage. Learn to respect your individual outlooks. Share your thoughts, your experiences, and your dreams with one another. Cherish the intimacy and the understanding that comes with the passage of time. As you enter this union, your belief that marriage is a partnership between equal individuals with common goals, hopes, and dreams will give your lives special meaning and fulfillment. There's a vast unknown future stretching out before you. But what a great tribute to your faith in each other that you are willing to face those uncertainties together. May the love you share grow deeper and more secure with every passing year. Today, we have gathered family and friends to celebrate the love and the union of Kyla and Kyla. They have gathered each of you here to be a part of this ceremony as they make this lifelong commitment to each other. Today, you are here to join both of your lives together. So we will now be doing a sand ceremony. These two separate vases of sand represent your separate lives before you found each other. They represent all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will be. Today, both of you will seal your bond by combining the contents of these individual vases. Once the sand is blended together, it cannot ever again be separated. So please, both of you, step up to the table and pour your sand into this central vessel. From the earliest times, the circle has been a symbol of completeness, a sign of abiding love. An unbroken circle represents a commitment of love that is never ending. These rings symbolize the ties that will bind you together as husband and wife. So I hope when either of you look at these rings, you'll be reminded of the enduring covenant to love and to honor each other that you are making today. Kyle, as you place the ring on Kyla's finger, please repeat after me. Kyla, I choose you to be my lifelong partner. I promise to listen. With compassion and understanding.
With compassion and understanding.
To learn and grow with you.
To learn and to grow with you.
On life's journey.
On life's journey.
To celebrate your triumphs and mourn your losses.
To celebrate your triumphs and mourn your losses.
As if they were my own.
As if they were my own.
I take you as you are and love without condition.
I take you as you are.
I am yours and you are mine.
I am yours and you are mine.
From this day until the end of my days.
From this day until the end of my days.
Kyla, as you place the ring on Kyle's finger, please repeat after me. Kyle, I choose you to be my lifelong partner.
Kyle, I choose you to be my lifelong partner.
I promise to listen.
I promise to listen.
With compassion and understanding.
With compassion and understanding.
To learn and grow with you.
To learn and grow with you.
On life's journey.
On life's journey.
To celebrate your triumphs and mourn your losses.
To celebrate your triumphs and mourn your losses.
As if they were my own.
As if they were my own.
I take you as you are and love without condition.
I take you as you are and love without condition.
I am yours and you are mine.
I am yours and you are mine.
From this day until the end of my days.
From this day until the end of my days.
Kyle and Kyla, you have given yourselves to each other in unselfish love. You have made a solemn vow to each other, a deliberate promise that come what may, for better and for worse, in sickness and in health, you will be true and faithful to each other. But before I pronounce you husband and wife, there's just one more thing I want you to do. This wedding day is going to fly by so quickly. It's a day filled with emotion and family, friends, vows, and rings. So I want you to take a few seconds now to just look into each other's eyes. Think about the happiness that you're feeling right now in this beautiful place, in this beautiful moment. And really let that feeling register in your heart and your mind. Now I want you to think about your life together in 20 years. Where are you? What will you be doing? We all know that your visions of the future are not identical, but they are always complementary. John Lennon once said, "A dream you dream alone is only a dream. A dream you dream together, that is reality." And that new reality starts now. And remember, marriage isn't just about finding the right partner. It's about being the right partner. I would like to close with a favorite wedding blessing. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter for the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there will be no loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. May beauty surround you both in the journey ahead and through all the years. And may happiness be your companion and your days together be good and long upon the earth. Kyle and Kyla, as you have consented together this day to enter into the holy bonds of marriage, and having pledged and sealed your vows by the giving and receiving of rings, by the power vested in me, it is my joy and personal privilege to pronounce you married. You may now kiss. Outside to join Kyle and Kyla for the ribbon wand. Thank you so much.